Hi students, today we are discussing about the topic is multiplication of bacteriophages. Bacteriophage means the virus which attack bacteria. Phage means virus. The virus which attack bacteria is called bacteriophage. The multiplication of bacteriophages. Bacteriophage multiplication takes place by two methods. First one is Leydig cycle. And second one is lysogenic cycle. Bacteriophage multiplication takes place by two methods. First one is Leydig cycle and second one is lysogenic cycle. First, Leydig cycle. The virus that caused the lysis of the bacterial cell wall. Leydig means lysis. Lysis means breakdown. Breakdown of a cell wall. Or death of the bacteria. After the death of the bacteria, the newly formed virus particles released from the bacterium cell. Hence, the virus that involves in the Leydig cycle are called as virulent phages. Virulent phages means the virus particle that causes the immediate lysis of the bacterial cell wall. Immediate lysis. Lysis means breakdown of the cell wall or death of the bacteria. It leads to the releasing of the newly formed virus particles. Hence, the phages are also called as virulent phages. The viruses that involves in the Leydig cycle are called as virulent phages. That means immediate lysis of the cell wall, bacterial cell wall. And the Leydig cycle occurs in 5 steps. It occurs in 5 steps. First step is adsorption. Adsorption or attachment. Second one is penetration. Second step, penetration. And third step, biosynthesis. Fourth step, maturation. And the fifth step, lysis or release. Leydig cycle occurs in 5 steps. First step is adsorption or attachment. The virus or the bacteriophage that attached to the complementary receptor sites of the bacterial cell through the tail fibers is called as attachment or adsorption. This is the diagram of bacteria and this one is the bacteriophage or the virus particle. The bacteriophage that attached to the complementary receptor site of the bacterial cell is called as adsorption or attachment through the tail fibers. By the presence of tail fibers, the bacteriophages are attached to the bacterial cell wall is called as adsorption. This is the first step. Next, Second step is penetration. This is the phage DNA or virus DNA. Second step, penetration means the phage DNA that enters into the bacterial cell, that is called penetration stage. Phage DNA enters into the bacterial cell is called as penetration. The tail sheath, contract and form a holes in the bacterial cell wall. Hence, the phage DNA that enters into the bacterium cell is called as penetration. Next, ghost. Ghost means a protein coat or capsule. Only the phage DNA enters into the bacterium cell, but the protein coat or capsid is present outside of the bacterial cell. Bacterial cell wall, hence is called as ghost. Ghost is a protein capsid. It is a protein capsid present outside of the host cell or bacterial cell is called as ghost. Only the phage DNA that enters into the bacterium cell. Protein coat or capsid is present outside of the bacterial cell is called as ghost. This is the second stage, penetration. Next, third stage, biosynthesis. After the phage DNA enters into the bacterium cell, the phage DNA replicates in the bacterium cell and form phage DNA particles, head, protein capsids, tails, tail pins and tail fibers are synthesized. Hence, this stage is called as biosynthesis stage. Phage DNA after entering into the bacterium cell, they occupies the total machinery of the bacterium cell, and the phage DNA in the bacterium cell starts replicating and produces head, tail pins and DNA particles are synthesized. Hence, this stage is called biosynthesis stage. This is the third step, biosynthesis. Next, fourth step, maturation. Maturation means the newly formed parts are assembled, head, phage DNA, tails, tail pins, tail fibers. All the parts are assembled in the bacterium cell and form a newly formed virus particles. These are called virions. Virions means newly formed virus particles in the bacterium cell is called virion. After the biosynthetic stage, the newly formed particles are assembled. All the parts are assembled to form a complete virion. Virion means a virus particle that is present outside of the host cell is called virion, and this stage is called maturation. Next, indulone eclipse stage. Eclipse stage means it is the stage between infection by a virus and newly formed virus particle. in the Batelian cell. This stage is called eclipse stage. It is the stage between the infection by a virus and newly formed virus particles in the Batelian cell. This stage is called eclipse stage, and the total stage is called maturation stage. Maturation stage means new virus particles are synthesized. All the parts are assembled to form a complete virus particles. These are called virions. Hence, this stage is called maturation stage. And last, fifth stage. The fifth stage is the lysis or release. This is the last stage of the Leydig cycle. In this stage, newly formed virus particles releases some a viral enzyme called lysozyme. The newly formed virus particles releases a viral enzyme. The viral enzyme called lysozyme. These lysozyme enzyme degrades the bacterial cell wall, and the newly formed virus particles released from the bacterium cell is called lysis or release. Burst size 2 marks bit. Burst size means the number of newly formed virus particles released from the bacterium cell is called burst size. The number of newly formed virus particles released from the host cell is called as burst size. The number of newly formed virus particles released from the phage or released from the host cell is about 50 to 200 virus particles released from the bacterium cell or host cell. This is the burst size. And next one is lysogenic cycle, second stage of bacteriophage multiplication is lysogenic cycle. The viruses that involves in the lysogenic cycle, they do not cause lysis or death. They do not cause the lysis or death of the host cell. These type of virus particles are called as temperate phages. Two marks B. What is the difference between virulent phages and temperate phages? This is a 2 marks B. Virulent phage means the virus that involves in the Leydig cycle and it causes the immediate lysis of the bacterium cell. The phages are called virulent phages. Temperate phages means the viruses that involves in the lysogenic cycle, they do not cause immediate lysis of the bacterium cell. Hence, the phages are called temperate phages. Temperate phages means the virus, they do not cause the immediate lysis or death of the host cell. Hence, the phages are called as temperate phages. In this cycle, the phage DNA after entering into the bacterium cell, this is the phage DNA. Phage DNA after entering into the bacterium cell, the phage DNA integrated or incorporated with the bacterial DNA. The phage DNA particle integrated or incorporated with integrated with the bacterial DNA to form a prophase DNA. Prophase means phage DNA that incorporated with the bacterial DNA. This is a bacterial DNA and this one is the phage DNA. The phage DNA that incorporated with bacterial DNA to form a inactive stage of DNA is called as prophase DNA or prophase DNA. If the bacterial DNA replicates, the phage DNA, prophase DNA also replicates, but latent in the progeny cells. Latent means inactive. If the phage DNA that enters into the lytic cycle, they cause the immediate lysis of the bacterium cell. But the phage DNA that enters into the lysogenic cycle, the phage DNA integrated with bacterial DNA to form a prophase DNA. It is a latent stage, that means inactive stage of DNA that is present in the progeny cells. If the bacterial DNA replicates, the prophase DNA also replicate, but they are latent in the progeny cells. Hence, this cycle is called lysogenic cycle. If some spontaneous processes, the prophase DNA treated with UV radiation. If the prophase DNA treated with UV radiation, the prophase DNA separates from the bacterial DNA and enters into lytic cycle. Or sometimes they treated with some chemicals. If the prophase DNA treated with some chemicals, the prophase DNA separates from the bacterial DNA and enters into the lytic cycle, and it causes the lysis of the bacterium cell. This stage is called lysogenic cycle.